I'm Lynn Marie Rosenberg, and here we are again, taking out some more trash. So, there's another breakdown currently circulating the internet that has caused a lot of people a lot of harm. I will read it to you. This is what it initially appeared as. Abdul Kahar, a mysterious Muslim man, 26, but the Middle Eastern desert wreaked havoc on his skin, making him appear older. Thinks Jenny Craig is married to Mr. Craig of Craigslist, so has much to learn about American culture and himself. Who still talks about Craigslist? This is a casting notice that was sent specifically to the Manassa Artists Coalition page on Facebook in hopes of helping with casting. For anyone who is not familiar, Manassa stands for Middle Eastern, North African, and South Asian. After receiving considerable backlash yesterday from the Manassa community on this Facebook page, the theater, Transformation Theater Incorporated, is trying to claim now that this language was not supposed to go out, but the only way for it to have been received is for the person who posted it to have been given it. So even if you're willing to give them that, at some point this language was written by the playwright and considered okay to be affiliated with this project. I want to also read a section of what, as of yesterday afternoon, the play description included on NPX, National Play Exchange. By the evening, there was a completely different plot, and then by this morning, the playwright's page no longer exists on NPX. This is harder than you think. Abdul Kahar's betrayal is revealed as Arthur and Kenny learn that their guest is not a CIA informant, but an Al-Qaeda terrorist. Will Abdul Kahar go through with the terrorist attack? What insights has he gained through his Rainbow's End sojourn that influence his ultimate decision? So we have Islamophobia, maybe a white savior narrative, this horrible, harmful, constant re-representation of Middle Eastern people as terrorists. All of this existed at some point in this play. I should note that the playwright is a white woman. As I said, this language now no longer appears as such, but we have screenshots. I was literally just looking at my phone and discovered that the theater has released a statement, and it includes this language. As always, our primary mission is to give voice to underrepresented and marginalized people through the production of new plays representing these communities. We support the Muslim community as well as all marginalized people and cultures. That's all well and good. I have a real easy solution for you to do this. Hire Muslim writers. Hire Middle Eastern writers. This is not a conversation we should be having anymore in 2021. I should not have to make these videos anymore. I don't want to make these videos. I want to sit in my living room and paint. That's all I want to do. But I have to keep making these stupid videos. No one wants to stare at my stupid face anymore. But this is the thing. Not enough people that have a face that looks like mine are yelling about these things. So I have to keep releasing these stupid videos. They're not stupid. I'm very proud of the work that I've done. I am so sick of making these. This is not what I want to be doing. But when something like this slips so far, gets so far into the process that this sort of harm is caused, then we've gone nowhere. We've solved nothing. It's 2021 and we have solved nothing. Stop hiring white people to tell stories of non-white people. Stop hiring non-disabled people to tell disabled stories. Stop hiring neurotypical performers to portray neurodiverse characters. This is not a hard argument. I'm so tired of taking out this trash.